Masking filters are tools that let you selectively enhance parts of your photo, adjusting things like exposure or color in specific areas, giving you precise control over your edits. Today we'll go through how these filters work in Lightroom. When you open an imported image in Lightroom, this is how the main menus look like. And you have the masking menu here. Tap on it to enter into the menu. Tap the plus button to see all the options for creating masks. The first three need AI processing on cloud, need to be online to process these. The next three filters are added manually, and the last two are range masks. First, we're going to start with the manual filters, selecting the brush filter. Now you can see the main mask here and the brush filter I added underneath now, which is clipped to the main mask. The three options for the brush mask on the left and a toggle to see the mask on the top right. The three options for the brush mask. The first one is to increase or decrease the size of the brush. The second is to adjust the feather of the brush. Increasing it makes the edges softer. Reducing it makes for harder edges. The third option adjusts the flow or the opacity of the brush. In this particular example, I'm going to target the sail on this vintage ship. Zooming in, I'm going to reduce the feather of the brush for more hardened edges. Pressing on the sail to create a mask. You can see I have overdone it with the mask spilling out. So I here will select the erase option and brush out the extra mask. For this mask, you have all these tools on the right. Here in light menu, increasing the brightness with exposure slider. Also contrast. Even now, you can use the erase option to brush out the mask if needed. This is one example of non-destructive editing. Tuning in the color menu now by increasing the saturation. In the effects now, making it more contrasty by sliding the dehaze slider towards right. You have the detail menu also. You can tap on the mask to return to the main screen of the masking filters. Long tapping on the image to show before and after. Now to the next filter, the linear gradient filter. Click on the image and drag to define the direction and length of the linear gradient. The filter will be applied in the direction of your drag. You'll see two lines indicating the starting and ending points of the gradient. To define the gradient, you can drag the lines or the center point of the gradient to reposition it. You can use the handles to control the width and feathering of the gradient. Dragging the endpoint further up can invert the mask too. An independent handle to rotate the gradient. Now you can adjust the settings in the right panel, such as exposure, contrast, saturation, and more. In this case, I'm going to reduce the exposure to make the sky more dark. Adding another linear gradient at the bottom to make that part darker too. Next, the radial filter. Radial filter allows you to apply adjustments in a circular or elliptical shape, creating a radial gradient effect. Tap on the image and drag to create a circular or elliptical shape. The filter will be applied inside the shape. On the left, you have the options to change the feather of the filter. Now you can adjust the settings in the right panel. On the radial filter, you'll see the handles that allow you to modify the size and shape of the radial filter. Long tapping on the filter gives you other options. Here I'll choose duplicate, which adds a duplicate filter with the same dimensions. You can move it to desired position. Adjusting the settings reflects on both the filters here. You can modify the filters independently too. You can see both the radial filters under the main mask here. Trying here to create a bright evening sun effect. Now we'll go into the range mask, starting with the color range mask. The color range mask in Lightroom is a powerful tool that allows you to make selective adjustments based on specific color ranges within an image. Move the pointer to the desired color in the image that you want to target for adjustments. Adjust the refine slider to control the range of colors affected by the mask. Here, for example, targeting the greens, which includes also the leaves on the trees. Now on the right, apply the adjustments as necessary. So basically, you are targeting the particular colors to change their exposure or even hues. Choosing the yellow color now, refining it to select only the yellows and changing its hues to turn them to blue. Before and after. Next to the luminance range mask. Luminance range mask allows you to make selective adjustments based on brightness levels within an image. On the right, to refine the selection, you have two options. One is to define the luminance range you want to target, and the outer ones help to smooth out the transitions between the selected and unselected luminance levels. After applying, you can make the adjustments as needed. Now, we'll go to the first three AI options, which are processed on cloud. So you have to be online while creating these masks. Starting with select subject option, tapping on it, and Lightroom instantly starts using its machine learning capabilities to automatically detect and select the subject. Even without a person in an image, it tries to detect the main subject, and the results are quite good. Now you can make adjustments to the selection as needed. Select sky works similarly. It creates a mask for the sky. Here I will try to make the sky look cooler by reducing its temperature in the color menu, which changes the complexion of the image. Long tapping on the mask reveals further options. You can hide a particular mask if needed. You can slide out to see more detailed descriptions. You can rename the mask too. You can duplicate and invert the mask also. You have also the flexibility to refine and control your adjustments further using add and subtract options. When using add option, it allows you to expand the area affected by the mask. Tap the plus minus button to add and create another filter on top of this. This is useful for broadening the impact of your adjustments or applying the same settings to multiple areas. Here, adding a linear gradient filter at the bottom on top of the subject filter. Now the adjustments affects both selected areas. You can add more filters if needed too. Subtract option works in a similar way. It removes the selection from particular areas. For example, here on the sky selection, I'm going to use the radial filter on the sun to remove it from the adjustments made so that the original warm colors remain unaffected. Select background isn't much different, as it just selects everything other than the subject, basically an inverted mask of select subject filter. But you can make some interesting effects from it. Other than working on exposure contrast, you can also turn the background completely white with some tinkering or change colors to get these kinds of interesting color overlay effects. Using subtract here with a linear gradient filter to limit the mask to make edits look more natural. Inverting the mask obviously will select only the subject. This mask is better with only the portraits with the background all at the same focal length. Subscribe for more for these kinds of videos. Thanks for watching.